So today we will see how to create forms in HTML. So using forms, we can take user's input. So here you can see that example. So here is one form, in that there is field first name, second is last name. And when this form is open, then in that we can enter the values and then click on submit. So let's see how we can create field like this in forms. So see here. So when we have to create the form, then we have to use form tag, opening form tag and closing form tag. And when we create a form, then we have to tell the user what we have created. So first we have to create a label. So in that we give message first name. So user will get that message. This is the first name. In this field, we have to enter first name. Then for taking that input, you have to use input tag, and in that type is equal to text. So when we use type as a text, so that text will be created. Then for that input, we can give different properties, like we can set ID of that, we can set a name of that field, we can set value of that also. So this is the by default value. When you don't enter anything, the John, it will be showing. Then for last name, same, just change the ID and name. Type is same, text field, and for ID, that is last name. So L name is given in ID and name. And by default, surname is, last name is Doe. So in this way, we can create a forms. After that, at the last, we have to create a button. So type, we have to set as a submit. So using that, we can create a button, which name of that button is submit, value is submit. So like this, we can create a form. And when we click on submit, action will be performed. So after form, we have given action property, and it will be redirect to the action underscore page dot php. So all the values will be redirected to the that PHP page. So let's see. So if you don't give any by default value, suppose I keep here blank. Then click on run. So there are no first name, last name. So suppose I say ABC and DEF. Then when I execute, by default that first name is set as ABC and last name is DEF. So like that we can give value. If you don't want, we can delete this attribute or property. So all of you getting how we can create this form in HTML? So instead of submit, if you want to give another name to your button, so I have given enter name, so enter will be visible on your button. So in this way, we can create a forms in HTML. So when we have to create a form, we have to use form tag, form element in HTML. Using that, we can start the form. Then when we have to create a text box, then we have to create a text field, then we have to use a input tag. Using input tag, we can use different attributes in the input tag. If we use type as a text, then it will be the input text field. If type is equal to radio, means we can create a radio button. We know that radio button. So there are three options are there. We can check one out of that, like MCQ questions. ABCD options are there, and we can click on any one of option. Then checkbox. So in checkbox, we can select more than one value also, or we can select zero value also. So that is checkbox. Then for creating a submit button, type is equal to submit. And if you are to create a normal button, then you can give type as a button. So in this way, we can create different forms, different values in the forms, like text field, radio button, checkbox, submit button, normal button. So first we have seen already how to create a first name and last name. That example we have seen. Then if we have to display any text on our form, then we have to use label element. So using label, we can display text on our form. So label having different attributes, like a table having ID attribute, we can set that ID having for attribute. So we can set that. Then if we have to create a radio button, then in input tag, we have to set type as a radio. In this way, we can set a radio button. So see here example of radio button. So this is the example. In that, we can click on any one of the radio button, male, female, like that. So for that, we have to give type as a radio, and then optional fields are, we can set ID, we can set name, we can set the values. So in this way, we can set the radio buttons in the HTML form. Then next, checkbox. How to create a checkbox in HTML form. So here we have to use type as checkbox. Then checkbox will be created in the HTML form. You can see here output. If you are having multiple vehicles, then you can check on that. I have a bike, I have a car. So if you are having multiple correct answers, then you can create a checkbox here. So here type is equal to checkbox you have to set for all the three. Car, bike, and boat. And ID names are optional field. If you delete that, still you will get output. Suppose I delete this, click on run, still I am getting the output. But when you have to access these fields in the next page, then you have to call using by ID or by name or by value. So that's why here that values are set. Then next, submit button. So for creating a submit button, type is equal to submit. So using that, we can create a submit button. So here you can see at the last, submit button is created in the first example we have seen. Then we know that for input tag, there are different attributes. First is the name. So we can set the name of that text field. So see here, if you don't set the name field, still it's okay, it will access. We can see the output here. Here you can see for that text field, only ID is set and value is set, name is not set. Still you will get output because that is not a compulsory field. But problem occurs here, it will not submit. That value will be not submitted because we can't access that text field. So that's why we have to give the name to that input element. Then there is exercise for the forms. So can you tell the answer? We have to create a button here. Then what I have to write here? Its value is okay. Then what I have to write here? You can type in chat also. Which tag I have to use? Which element we have to use? Whether we have to use HTML or body or head or which element I have to use in from HTML. Nobody knows. You can unmute and tell the answer, or you can type in chat also. Yes, Kranti. Pratiksha. All are here in class. Yes. How to create a button in HTML? Harshada says input type is equal to OK. Input type is equal to okay. This will work. Not correct. Any correction? How can we can create a button? Just we have seen how to create a button. Can anyone tell how to create a button? What is the type we have to give for text? Text field is given. Txt. And for button, what we have to write here? Namrata says input type is equal to button, value is equal to okay. Okay, we will try. Type is equal to button. Then value is equal to okay. Correct? So it is correct. Like this, we can create a button. type we have to set as a button and a value. Then next, here we have to create a radio button and its name as a gender. So tell the answer what I have to write here under the forms for radio button. Only Namrata and Harshada is giving answer. Others are there? So which tag I have to use here? You can unmute or you can type in chat. So I will give hint here. Tag we have to use as a input tag. Then what is the type I have to give for radio button? The name they have told that we have to set name as a gender. So like this, very simple. Third, Pallavi given good answer, correct answer. Next, here we have to create a form, and in that it will have a submit button. And when we click on submit, then this page will be open, next page. So what I have to use here? So here we have to use action, and for creating a submit button input, which type we are setting? Type is equal to submit, correct? So in this way we can create a submit button. Next, here we have to specify the post method. So that we will see how to submit that. All of you getting how to create a forms? Then forms having different types, like we have seen. Which are the types are there? Text type is there. Then next, radio button is there. Submit button is there. Then next, which are the buttons are there? Normal buttons are there. Drop downs are there. So see here. So these are the different input types we can create. First one is the button we can create. We can create a checkbox. We can set type as a color. If you want to take a date as input, then type is date. If you want in a local format date and time, then you can take, you can set date time dash local. You can set email ID. You can set type as a file. If you don't want to display that input, then you set type as a hidden. You can set type as an image. So like that, there are lot of types here. If you have to create a reset button, reset type is there. Radio button, radio. Then type is equal to password, means that text will not visible. Instead of that, you will get dots. So like this, there are different types are there. So this we have seen, text fields, password. So how to set a password? Here, type as a password. So let's see this. So username, you can set as admin, and for password, if I type any password, then it is not visible because type is password here, not text. Then if I change from password to the text, what will happen? Instead of password, I will write here text. Click on run. Then click on admin, and password is admin. So it is visible. So password type is giving security to your text. It will not visible when you type that. Type is equal to password in small. So now let's see, it is in dots. When you click on visible, then it will be showing. Then next, submit button. Already we have seen how to create a submit button. Type is equal to submit. So we can create a submit button. A reset button. So type is equal to reset. We can create a reset button. So like this, we can see here. So here is in first name and last name. When we click on a reset, then suppose I type here another values. And when I click on reset, original value will be shown here, which is the originally set by the developer of that form. If in that there are no by default values, so it is blank initially. When I type any values here and I don't want to submit again, I want to reset, then click on reset. So like that, we can reset the forms. It will show by default values. Next, radio button. Already we have seen that example, in that we have created a radio button by setting type is equal to radio. Then checkbox we have seen. Type is equal to checkbox. Using that, we can create a field as a checkbox. Then for button, type is equal to button. So you can see here what is the use of type color. So you can see here output, set your favorite color. And here you can set your favorite color like this. So this is the use of color. In that, color palette will be visible and you can set any one favorite color of yours. Color picker. Then date, when you have to take date as the input, what is the birth date? So like that, if you want to take birth date, then you can set type as a date, and in this way calendar will be open and you can set your birth date like this. What is the month, what is the date, like that, and you can submit. Then you can set the maximum and minimum value also for date in what is the range of your birth date. So you can set that minimum and maximum. Then date and time local. So here you can see date and time, and also time. What is the time you can set for that. So like that you can set time also. Then next, if you want to take input as an email ID, then you can set type as an email ID. And in this way, you can take input as an email ID. Suppose I given wrong values, then it will show error. Please include @ in the email address. Your email ID is @gmail.com or ready for Yahoo. Then if we have to create input as a field, like a browse button to upload a file, then we can set type as a file. And in this way, we can show the input here. So choose and it will open our systems folder. From that, we can choose and upload the file. So here for file, type is a file. Then hidden buttons. So that is not visible on the form. For example, here you can see hidden button is customer ID. So you can see on the form only first name is visible and the field hidden is not visible. If we use type as a text or any other field for that, then and then only it will be visible. Getting? But if we set it is as hidden, then only one field. Suppose first field we set as a hidden, then nothing will appear, only label will be appear. So like that, there are different types for selecting month of the year. Type is number. So when we have to give input as a number, then we can set type as a number, and in that we can set minimum and maximum value also. So let's see. So here is the input, and in that if suppose I enter 6 and try to submit, so it is showing value is greater than 5. If I enter 0, then also it is showing error message. Suppose I enter here a string. So this field is not taking any characters. Suppose I enter here 50. So like this, it is having a range 1 to 5 only. Here we can change minimum 10 to 50. Click on run. Now you can see it start from 10 till 50. So range will be increased when you set the value of min and max. Then some restriction you can apply on that. Suppose there is checkbox and which checkbox is checked, that you can set. You can disable that input field. You can set the maximum value in that field. You can set the maximum length. You can set the minimum length. You can set the pattern what the user can enter. You can set a read only. You can set a required, means that is compulsory. Then you can set its width, that is the size. Then you can set the values. So like that, the restrictions you can apply on that form. So here we have seen minimum and maximum range. And step means how that is increased by a value of 10, 10. And by default value is 30. So you can see here, value is increased by 10th interval till 100. If we change that interval from 10 to 1, then you can see value will be increased by the interval of 1. If we set it as a 20, then like this, it will be increased. Then you can set type as a range also. So here you can set the slider and you can set the values from 0 to 50. Then for search, you can create type as a search. So here you can see there is one search option is there using that you can search. So like this, you can search. Then for taking telephone number, we can set the pattern. Enter your phone number and we can give the pattern. So you can see here, like this, we can enter the phone number of 8 digits. If I try to enter characters here, it is showing. This is not correct format. So this is the format from 0 to 93, 3 numbers, 0 to 92 numbers, and 0 to 93 numbers, like that. Between that there is a dash. Like this, it will accept as per the required format. Then you can select week also. and there are some exercises that we have solved already. So today we stop here.